Welcome to the FixSleep Bedtime Stories Channel, your sanctuary for relaxation, meditation, and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this journey to relaxation. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our magical sleep stories. So, let the tale begin. The Rain Restaurant. Chapter 1. The Enigmatic Chef's Opening Night. The night air was charged with anticipation as the Rain Restaurant prepared to open its doors for the first time. Nestled in the heart of the bustling city, where the streets hummed with the energy of countless stories, the restaurant stood as an oasis of mystery. Its windows, frosted by the evening's gentle drizzle, offered no glimpse within, yet the golden light that spilled from its doorway promised a haven of warmth and wonder. Inside, the enigmatic chef, known to the city only through whispers of his culinary prowess, moved through the kitchen with a calm certainty. Surrounded by his brigade of chefs, each a master of their craft, he orchestrated the evening's menu with a precision that belied the storm of creativity raging in his mind. The dishes, inspired by the myriad forms of rain that graced the city throughout the year, were more than mere meals. They were an homage to the elemental dance between water and earth, air and sky. As the first guests arrived, their curiosity piqued by the promise of a dining experience unlike any other. They were greeted by the restaurant's host. Her smile was a beacon, guiding them through the dimly lit foyer and into the dining area, where tables draped in shades of blue and gray mirrored the evening sky outside. The ambiance was a carefully crafted symphony of light and shadow, each element from the decor to the cutlery echoing the theme of rain. The menu, presented on parchment that mimicked the texture of wet stone, offered a journey through the city's rainy seasons. From the gentle caress of a spring drizzle to the torrential downpours of the monsoon, each course promised a taste of the city as seen through the eyes of its most ardent admirer, the chef himself. The dishes, named after the various types of rain they represented, were a palette of flavors as diverse as the city's own cultural tapestry. As the evening unfolded, the guests found themselves transported. A starter inspired by the light, refreshing rain of early spring, brought with it the crisp flavors of young vegetables and herbs, each bite a whisper of new beginnings. The main course, evoking the fierce and invigorating monsoon, was a bold symphony of spices and textures, a reminder of the power of nature to transform and invigorate. The chef would come out with each meal to tell its tale, his voice a mix of nostalgia and enthusiasm. He talked of exploring the city's wet streets, obtaining supplies from its obscure corners, and the memories that each kind of rain brought back for its residents. The diners, who were listening intently to everything he said, weren't just eating. They were taking a sensory excursion outside the restaurant. The evening's crescendo came with the dessert, a delicate creation inspired by the misty rains of autumn, which brought with it the sweet, melancholic end of the rainy season. It was a masterpiece of flavors and textures, a final note that lingered on the palate long after the last bite had been savored. As the guests departed, the rain outside had ceased, but its essence filled the restaurant, lingering in the air like a promise. The Rain Restaurant, with its enigmatic chef and its menu of dreams, had woven a spell over its patrons, leaving them with a newfound appreciation for the city's rainy cloak and the flavors it inspired. In the quiet that followed the last guest's departure, the chef stood at the window, looking out at the city he loved. The night's success was but the first chapter in a story that was only beginning to unfold. The Rain Restaurant, a love letter to the city and its ever-changing skies, had found its place in the heart of the urban tapestry, a beacon for all who sought to discover the poetry of rain and the culinary magic it inspired. Chapter 2, The Culinary Critic's Quest. The culinary critic, known for her sharp palate and sharper pen, embarked on a quest that was more than a mere review. It was an investigation into the soul of the Rain Restaurant and the city that birthed it. Armed with nothing but her senses and an insatiable curiosity, she ventured into the night, her path illuminated by the soft glow of streetlights reflecting off the wet pavement. Her first stop was the city's night market, a cacophony of colors, sounds, and scents under the relentless drizzle. The critic moved among the stalls with purpose, each vendor offering a piece of the puzzle she sought to solve. She tasted spices that tingled her tongue, fruits that burst with the essence of rain, and street foods that carried the warmth of 1,000 homes. Each flavor was a note in the symphony of the city's culinary heritage, a heritage that the Rain Restaurant had woven into its menu. As the critic delved deeper into the market, she stumbled upon a vendor known for his exquisite herbal teas, each blend a tribute to the different types of rain that graced the city. Through him, she learned of the chef's visits, his quest for the perfect blend that captured the essence of a gentle spring shower. It was here, among the fragrant leaves and steaming cups, that the critic began to understand the chef's ambition to distill the transient beauty of rain into a taste that lingered on the palate. The critic's journey then led her to the hidden gardens of the city, urban oases tucked away between the towering skyscrapers. Here, in these pockets of green, she discovered the source of the restaurant's freshest ingredients. Each plant thriving on the life-giving rains that swept through the city. She spoke with the gardeners who tended these plots, each one sharing tales of the chef's visits. His hands digging into the earth alongside theirs, selecting the perfect produce for his dishes. With the night deepening and her notebook filled with scribbled insights, the critic found her way to the shores of the city's river, its waters swollen with the season's rains. It was here, watching the city reflected in the undulating surface, that she pieced together the narrative of the Rain Restaurant. It was not just a culinary venture. It was a love letter to the city and its rain, an attempt to capture its fleeting beauty and preserve it within the confines of a menu. The critic headed back to the Rain Restaurant as dawn broke, casting pink and gold hues over the sky. She became aware that her journey had involved more than just finding the key to the restaurant's success as the city began to awaken around her. It had been a tour around the center of the city, learning about the ways that rain influenced its culture, identity, and tastes. Sitting down to write her review, the critic found herself at a loss for words. How could she convey the depth of her experience, the myriad ways in which the restaurant had intertwined itself with the city's essence? Her review, when it finally flowed from her pen, was more than an evaluation of a culinary experience. It was a testament to the chef's genius, a narrative that wove together the critic's journey through the city's rain-drenched streets, the stories of the people she had met, and the tastes that had captivated her palate. In the end, the critic realized that the rain restaurant's secret was the city itself, its rain, its people, its stories. The enigmatic chef had merely opened the door to a world where every drop of rain told a tale, and every dish served was a chapter in the city's ongoing saga. Chapter 3, A Taste of the City's Soul. The culinary critic's exploration of the rain restaurant's menu was more than a mere tasting. It was an odyssey through the city's soul, guided by flavors that spoke of rain's influence on culture, tradition, and culinary innovation. Each dish presented to her was a chapter in the city's story, a narrative woven from the essence of rain that permeated every aspect of urban life. Her journey began with an appetizer inspired by the gentle drizzle of early spring, a dish that captured the fresh, hopeful essence of the season. The ingredients, tender young greens and herbs, were sourced from the city's urban farms, places of verdant growth amidst concrete, where rain was both a cherished resource and a catalyst for life. The critic learned of the farmers' meticulous methods to capture rainwater, nurturing their crops with the purity of the season's first showers. The dish, light and invigorating, was a homage to the city's cycle of renewal, a taste of the new beginnings that each spring rain promised. As the menu progressed, the critic was presented with a course inspired by the summer monsoon, the season when the city came alive with the energy of thunderstorms. This dish was a bold celebration of the monsoon's intensity, featuring robust flavors and spices that mirrored the tempestuous weather. The ingredients told stories of the markets, where vendors hawked their wares under the protection of rain-soaked awnings, their shouts mingling with the rumble of thunder. The critic discovered the spice merchants, who revered the monsoon as a time of peak demand. Their spices, a vital ingredient in the city's culinary repertoire, imbued with the power to warm the soul against the chill of torrential rains. Following the monsoon's fury, the critic tasted a dish that evoked the serene beauty of rain showers at dusk, a time when the city seemed to pause and reflect. The ingredients, a blend of evening harvested vegetables and nocturnal blooms, spoke of the city's night gardens, hidden sanctuaries that flourished under the cover of darkness. The dish was a revelation, its flavors a testament to the city's ability to find tranquility amid the chaos of daily life. A reminder of the moments of peace that dusk rains brought to the urban landscape. The final course was a dessert inspired by the first frosty rains of winter, a farewell to the year's cycles of precipitation. This dish was a complex interplay of cool and warm elements, mirroring the juxtaposition of winter's chill with the warmth of communal gatherings. The critic learned of the city's winter festivals, celebrations that defied the cold with feasts, music, and shared stories. The ingredients, sourced from the last harvest before the winter set in, were a tribute to the city's resilience, its capacity to find joy and abundance in the face of seasonal adversity. Through each dish, the critic unraveled the fabric of the city's relationship with rain, understanding how it influenced not just the flavors of its cuisine, but the rhythm of its people's lives. The Rain Restaurant, with its menu deeply rooted in the city's climatic heartbeat, offered not just a culinary experience, but an immersion into the soul of the urban environment. As she concluded her tasting, the critic realized that the restaurant's true magic lay in its ability to encapsulate the essence of the city, its diversity, its challenges, and its celebrations within the confines of a menu. The enigmatic chef, through his culinary creations, had not only paid homage to the city and its seasons of rain, but had also invited his patrons to embark on a journey of discovery, to taste the soul of the city as it unfolded with each drop of rain. Chapter 4, The Revelation. As the culinary critic sat down to compose her review of the Rain Restaurant, she found herself reflecting not just on the meals she had tasted, but on the journey she had undertaken. The city, with its ever-present rain, had always been a backdrop to her work, a setting for her culinary explorations. Yet, through the lens of the restaurant's menu, she had come to see the city in a new light, a place where rain was not merely a meteorological phenomenon, but a source of life, inspiration, and communal connection. The critic's journey had led her through the city's rain-drenched streets to markets, gardens, and hidden corners, each encounter revealing a facet of how rain influenced the local cuisine and culture. From the vendors at the night market with the rain-kissed produce, to the urban farmers capturing rainwater to nourish their crops, she had seen how the city's inhabitants embraced and adapted to the rhythm of the rain. Her revelations reached deeper, touching on the social and cultural significance of rain in the city. She recalled the stories shared with her by those she met. Tales of monsoon festivals where communities came together to celebrate the life-giving rain. Of artists and poets inspired by the beauty of a rain-soaked cityscape. And of families gathering to share meals that brought warmth and comfort during the rainy season. At the heart of her discoveries was the Rain Restaurant itself, a place that had distilled the essence of the city's relationship with rain into a culinary experience. The enigmatic chef, with his menu inspired by different types of rain, had not just created a series of dishes, but had crafted an ode to the city and its rhythm of precipitation. Each course was a chapter in a larger story, inviting diners to taste the soul of the city through the flavors brought forth by the rain. The critic's review, as she began to write, was not just an evaluation of the restaurant's culinary merits, but a narrative of her journey and the revelations it had brought. She wrote of the dishes that had captivated her palate, of the chef's genius in translating the nuances of rain into culinary creations, and of the deeper understanding of the city she had gained through her experiences. As her review was published, it sparked a conversation among the city's residents, food enthusiasts, and cultural commentators. The Rain Restaurant became a symbol of the city's unique relationship with rain, a culinary landmark that celebrated the natural cycle that shaped the lives of its inhabitants. critic's review, with its insights into the cultural and communal significance of rain, elevated the discourse on the role of culinary arts in reflecting and shaping urban identity. In the weeks and months that followed, the Rain Restaurant saw an influx of diners eager to experience the menu that had captured the imagination of the city. The critic, her name now synonymous with the discovery of the restaurant's deeper story, found herself reflecting on the impact of her work. She had begun her journey seeking to uncover the secret behind the restaurant's success, but had found something far more valuable: a renewed connection to the city and its rhythm of rain, and a deeper appreciation for the ways in which food could bring people together to celebrate their shared heritage and environment. As the seasons changed and the rains came and went, the Rain Restaurant remained a place where the city's residents could come together to share in the experience of dining under the influence of rain. The critic, her review a now famous ode to the city's culinary landscape, continued to explore the intersections of food, culture, and environment in her work. Forever changed by her revelation at the Rain Restaurant,